Students, welcome to Shorab Sir classes. My name is Professor Himadri Datta. So we are solving the IAS 2014 General Equilibrium, General Economics Paper 1. So we are just focusing on the section B. So today we'll do a question. We'll solve a question from section B, the question number 3. So first what I'll do is I'll just read out the question so it will be easier for you to have an understanding of what they are asking for. So the demand for good X is estimated to be Q equals to something. So the demand function is given, which looks like this. Q equals to 250,000 minus 500P minus 1.5M minus 240PR. So this is the demand for good X equation is given by this. Now here the PM and PR, the values of P is given by 200, the values of M is given by 600 60,000, the value of PR is given by 100. Calculate the price elasticity of demand for income elasticity of demand and cross price elasticity. So what we have to do is that first we have to find the value of Q. Now how do we find the value of Q? For this, first we have to put the value of P, A and PR here, here and here. So if you do so, we'll get it to be like this. Q equals to 25,000 minus 1.5 into 60,000 minus 240 into 100. Now if you solve this, we'll get the value to be equals to 56,000. So we have found the value of Q to be equals to 56,000. Now we'll write it down on the right hand side, so that if we need it later, we'll use this value. Okay, so now what we have found is that, so this is what we have so far. Now what we'll do is that the question goes like this. The first question, find out the EP, that is price elasticity. Now how do we find out the price elasticity? We remember the price elasticity formula is like this: change in Q by change in P into P by Q. Here the change in Q by change in P, if you differentiate this with respect to P, you will get minus 500, sorry, and the P is given by 200 and the Q is given by, as you can see from here, the Q is given by 56,000. Now if you solve this equation, we'll get the value of EP to be equals to minus 2.78. So the value of EP is equals to 2.78. Now we are asked to find the elasticity of money. For elasticity of money, we have to do the same thing, that is change in Q by change in M into M by Q. Now if you differentiate Q with respect to M, we'll get minus 1.5 into M is given by 60,000 and we have found Q to be equals to 56,000. So we'll get this. Now if you solve this, we'll find the value of EM to be equals to minus 2.5. So you have found the value of EM to be equals to minus 2.5. So EP was minus 0.27, EM is equals to minus 2.5. Now what we'll do is we'll simply have to find EPR, that is the cross price elasticity. The equation for cross price elasticity is that change in Q by change in PR into PR by Q. So now if you do this again, we'll get 240 here into PR is given by 100, and we have found the value of Q to be 56,000. Now if you solve this equation, we'll get the value to be 0.67. So we are being able to find the value elasticity for money, for elasticity for the price of other good, and the elasticity for income. So now what the question goes like this. Second question, is the demand for X elastic, inelastic or unit elastic? How would a small increase in P affect the total revenue? Since elasticity of price elasticity is equals to 2 point, if you take mod, we'll get the absolute value, which is more than, which is greater than 1, we conclude that the demand for X is elastic. So demand for X is elastic. So we conclude that the demand for X commodity is elastic. Now, when a price increases by a small amount, the rate of decrease in demand will be more than increase in price because of the demand. So the revenue falls. Now, as the price elasticity is more, when price increases, we already know that the quantity demanded falls. Now this fall in quantity demanded, fall in quantity demanded will be more than fall in increase in price because of elastic property. So then what will happen, that as a result the revenue will grow down, because revenue is price into quantity. So when quantity fall is more than price increase, the revenue as a whole will fall. So that we have attempted to answer the second question, what will happen to total revenue. The total revenue will fall when price increases. Now third question, is good X normal or inferior? Are the good X and Y substitutes or complements? How will you answer this? For this, what we have to do is, since EM is minus 2.5, as you can see, which is less than 0, as elasticity for money is less than 0, the good X is inferior. Now, if you know the definition of inferior commodity is that when your income increases, what happens to the demand for that commodity? We usually know for normal commodity, when demand in price increases, or sorry, when income increases, you are likely to consume more of that commodity. But in case of inferior good, when income increases, you are likely to sacrifice that commodity for consumption of other commodities. So when your demand falls, even when income increases, we call the commodity to be an inferior commodity or inferior good. So now the next question goes like this. Is it a substitute or a complement? For this, what we have to do is, we have to write down, since EPR, which we have found it to be 0.67, which is greater than 0. So you'd say the goods are substitute. When this is greater than 0, we conclude that the goods are substitute. That is, a one good could be exchanged for other good when price increases. So today we talked about the question number 3 from IES 2014 General Economics Paper 1 Section B. So we'll continue our discussion with this section only. In the next class, and in the next video, we'll talk about the question number 4. If you have any doubt or query regarding these questions, you can WhatsApp me on this number, which is 9836793076, or also you can go to our website, which is www.shourabsirclasses.com. There you will find a lot of other videos like this, and you will get the study material for IAS exam, which is coming in the 2019. Thank you for watching this video. If you have any query or doubt, you can WhatsApp me or you can directly go to our website. Thank you for watching this video. Have a nice day ahead.